Dr. Ramo, we know that women have used hormone replacement therapy for a long time. There's pros and cons. Now more men are using it. Should men be using this?
Well, it's a good question. In fact, many of my patients, when they come into the office, want to know, should they be on testosterone? So we measure testosterone levels, and the levels are low. They're having a problem with their sex drive. They may be tired, maybe aren't thinking as clearly as they have been normally. They want to know whether they should take testosterone or not. Well, the studies suggest that we simply don't know the real answer. For example, one study showed that they had to terminate the study when they compared the testosterone to the placebo. After 6 months, there were more heart attacks. Now there's a very large study from the National Institutes of Health of 8,000 patients looking at placebo versus testosterone. So I will tell you that there is some evidence, however, that testosterone builds bones, it builds muscles, and we know that from the athletes who take it. So there's some beneficial effects, but it's not all exactly for sure excellent.
All right, so you got to talk to your doctor, because at this point it's kind of up in the air whether, you know, as a man you should be taking this hormone.
Well, the real question is whether or not it increases your risk for cancer. Nope. We do not know that and won't know that for some time. But for men who are fatigued, men who are having problems with bone loss particularly, it may be worthwhile. The cardiovascular effects with the gels are not bad. With the tablets, they may be bad. But I think if a man is having these problems, talk to your doctor, get your testosterone level measured, and maybe try it for a brief period of time.
All right, Dr. Ramo, thank you. You can find more HealthBeat topics and this topic at KOAT.com.